I'm Baraka Muganda for Sola Fide. Today I want to talk on living an authentic life. Therefore, each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthful to your neighbor, for we are all members of one body, Ephesians 4 verse 25. With very few exceptions, most of us do not start a day planning to be liars. You do not start the day by asking yourself, how am I going to lie today? But many times lying creeps in our lives without an prior planning. Yes, I'm talking about lying. Lying can be a huge problem in church or any organization as well. The Bible is so clear about the ugliness of lying. The Ten Commandments cover it, and throughout the scripture, we find condemnation and consequences of this behavior. God wants us to live authentic, genuine lives. Our text today, my friend, emphasizes the importance of truthful nature we are to embody. I was blown up by the introduction of the book of Ephesians. Its greeting, it says, to God's holy people in Ephesus, to God's people, the holy ones, the faithful ones in Jesus Christ. Colossians opens with, to God's holy people in Colossae, the faithful brothers and sisters in Christ. These first readers were holy. They were faithful in Christ, yet they still were instructed to speak truthful and not to lie. We too may claim to be Christians, working or studying on this great church, but have this problem of lying. We need to hear the voice of God speaking to us today. Doesn't matter which church you go to. Speak truthful and not lying to other people. This is the subtle falsehoods that creep in, frequency out of selfishness and fear. These might show up in our lives as harboring secret habits, wearing masks to be something we are not, hiding our hurts, withholding truth. These make us lie, thinking one thing and doing another. Today, I ask you, my friend, a question. Are you what you seem to be? If not, what do you need to do to make some changes in your life so that you become the authentic person? Reread our text for today and stop doing what these verses tell us to stop doing. Don't forget about the creep in factor. Consider the subtle ways falsehood has crept into your life. Then commit to stop doing those subtle things. Lying will not save you. Lying will destroy you. And today I want to encourage you, be faithful, be truthful, because God loves you. Thank you so very much.